Winter in the White Mountains of New Hampshire. Home of the worst weather in America. This expedition takes us into the heart of the Pemigewasset Wilderness, east of the Franconia Range. After driving north through the Franconia Notch, the first night will be spent in a comfortable lodge near the base of Mount Cleveland. Early the next morning, we will proceed over the top of our first and highest peak, Mount Garfield, then down to a campsite deep in the valley on the remote south side. The next morning begins a grueling hike around the back side of Owl's Head, our second major peak, then back down to flatter terrain and out the Pemigewasset Wilderness down an abandoned railroad bed, a total of 23 miles, a certain death march. Planning for this trip begins weeks in advance. Electronically, team members select a route. The Appalachian Mountain Club Bible is consulted for trail descriptions. Mount Garfield and Owl's Head are two of the 46 peaks over 4,000 feet. Peak baggers keep detailed records of climbs in order to earn that coveted 4,000-footer club patch.
In addition to all the planning, the weeks of preparation includes making sure that all this highly specialized equipment is in top working order. The clothes I'm wearing would only be used in the worst possible conditions, stuck on a mountaintop overnight in a blizzard, on the brink of exhaustion, after having fallen through the ice, soaking wet, shivering, water starting to freeze on the skin, tent ripped by sub-zero gales, pack lost down a cliff, no way to start a fire, hoping that frostbite won't set in before morning, when you'll start the 12-mile trek out in waist-deep snow with no energy left and no sleep, hoping you won't become just another statistic.
Some of this equipment is normal summertime stuff, but slightly modified for winter use. For example, the boots are plastic with insulator inside. Drinking cup, double insulated. And a canteen here with an insulated sleeve. And of course, socks. Everyone's got to have those with a little extra battery power for a boost. And some other equipment here is, of course, very specialized. There's the snowshoes, crampons for walking on ice, and an ice axe for a self-arrest as you go sliding down a glacier. Now, the idea is to get it all in this little old pack. Let's see here. Okay, that should do it, believe it or not, it's all in here. Now, let's take it out for a spin. As you can see, the weight has to be packed high to keep it over your feet No way. You get. Well, okay, as you can see, this takes a little practice. Now, let me get back to what I wanted to show you. What I have here, common garden variety bathroom scale. What every good hiker wants to do is weigh their pack. Okay, let's see. Looks like about 190 pounds. Now, take this off. Okay, and 143.
Adding that to 10 pounds of woolen stuff and heavy boots, that comes out to 57 pounds of pure hell.
We arrive in the lodge the night before and are up well before the crack of dawn. This is time for one last check of the equipment, making sure everything is in tip-top working shape.
Beautiful gourmet breakfast.
Even though the trailhead is only 2 miles away, packing is just as difficult as ever. Our hike begins at the intersection of Route 3 and the Trudeau Road. Just after dawn, we encounter the unexpectedly difficult Thompson Brook. By noon, we hope to reach the summit of Mount Garfield, 6 miles away. Our first major obstacle, Thompson Brook. Usually in winter, rivers are frozen, but this winter has been exceptionally warm.
It's a cold day today. Leaving for this hike?
Yeah.
I'm sweating and I'm chilling.
I got 2260. 200 foot difference.
2460.
Thank you.
breaking into the sun at 4,000 feet. Just 0.2 from the summit. Good maneuvering over the slippery trail. He who wears no crampons.
As we approach the summit of Mount Garfield, the trail becomes steeper and more difficult. Conditions here consists of a nice layer of snow, powdery snow, here, but underneath is glare
consists
ice.
Consists of a nice layer of snow, powdery snow, but underneath is glare ice. That's why we need crampons all the time.
Some people don't like to wear crampons.
Yeah, the axe makes a difference.
Finally, the summit of Mount Garfield. Franconia Range. Owl's Head, our destination for tomorrow, Mount Cannon. New Hampshire's famous fur waves.
Such fun. Hi, Mom.
finally, at 3 p.m., we reached the campsite at the bottom of the valley. Setting up on platforms normally used in the summer. This turned out to be a bad idea because it's very cold on top of the platforms.
What are we cooking?
Not Pop-Tarts. I think we'll have the beef stroganoff tonight. Finish it off a little with bread. Crunch like a cup, sir.
Rock.
Ranch omelet. Somebody likes ranch omelet. Food of champions combos.
Water has to be gathered from the nearby streams.
Look at a beautiful sight. Water. Nature's perfect food. Is it luscious or isn't it?
Mm.
What are we calling it?
Rice pilaf.
Rice kamikaze?
In the waning hours of the evening.
Oh, whoever picked 13 walls timed it right. I thought for sure we'd make it a lot earlier than this.
Finishing dinner.
Hey, come.
And getting ready to go to bed.
This is the morning garbage. It's our breakfast.
We've already been up for an hour and a half. Bright-eyed, bushy-tailed. Breakfast all et.
This really is the morning now.
Really?
Home sweet home, getting put away.
Watches. Hours spent determining the elevation so we can set the altimeter.
I have like 21.
No sooner do we start out than we come to yet more treacherous river crossings.
Holy Christ! Shit! Holy mackerel! I got one thing to do extra anyway.
Probably ought to move off that too.
Camouflaged section of ice over a waist deep. Swamp.
Wanna warm your hands up for a
second? No, I'm pretty warm. I'll just keep these and. Come on, one more layer. Take one more layer off.
At this point, the trail becomes very obscure, overgrown, not maintained for years, very difficult to find.
Day 23.
From this vantage point, it's possible to get the first glimpse of Owl's Head through the trees.
Those frightful river crossings, they never end. Yesterday, we reached the summit of Mount Garfield on schedule and had lunch at the Garfield Ridge campsite. Then we proceeded down to the campsite at 13 Falls, where we spent the night. This morning, we began a long walk along the backside of Owl's Head, where we found those treacherous, unexpected river crossings. And then we headed toward the intersection with the Owl's Head slide.
Viola, the Owl's Head cairn.
The 1 mile trail to the summit of Owl's Head is an open, icy slide.
This is the Owl's Head slide, extremely steep, but even carrying a full pack, the explorers approach. Could it be? Yes, this is the summit of Owl's Head. Unfortunately, it's 1:16 p.m. and we are in deep trouble.
Day 24. We haven't had food or water for 13 days. We're living on squirrel meat. We make it to Owl's Head Peak.
As the explorers approach.
In trouble is right. All downhill for only 3 hours of walk to cover 4 miles, back down the deadly slide, and across the two largest rivers on the trip, Lincoln and Franconia Brook. The Lincoln Brook, the wide, was amazingly easy. Finally, in the late afternoon, with only minutes of useful daylight, we reached the dreaded Franconia Brook to be, and then it sank, as if the river was everything.
After wasting another half hour
looking for an alternative, we just...
Shouldn't be a problem.
Glug, glug.
Mother Z Squad.
Decided there was no choice but to plunge right in.
Yay!
Got water in my boots!
Looks like Paul thinks he can stay dry.
Total darkness to walk 5 more miles down the wilderness trail and command this highway.
Up you go. You all right?
A record 23 miles into a very long winter day.
The
cast, Scott Scooter Charade. Steve Ives. Paul Cummings. And your reporter, Maury Gasser.
Well, okay, as you can see, it takes a little practice.